Hello everyone, namaste and welcome back to the channel. I hope you're all doing fine and safe. My name is Nirjana Banikya, legal intern at Lexis and Company. Today I will be discussing one topic from contract law. Now guys, let us see what is the topic and let us further discuss the topic. The topic that we'll be discussing today is contract of indemnity. Now, to begin with, let us see the section and the act. So, do you all know which act or what Indian law is for the contract? Well, it is known as the Indian Contract Act 1872. Now, guys, the section for contract of indemnity is section 124 of the Indian Contract Act 1872. Now let us see what is contract of indemnity. Alright, now let us see what is contract of indemnity. Contract of indemnity is a contract which is made by one party promising the other party to protect the party from any kind of loss suffered because of them or any other party. So this is what contract of indemnity means. Alright, so guys, we already know that for a contract there must be at least two parties, right? So in contract of indemnity we similarly have two parties. One party is called the indemnifier and the other party is called indemnified or indemnity holder. Now let us discuss them one by one. So guys, indemnifier means the person who makes the promise, and indemnified or indemnity holder means the person who is benefit of the promise. To be more clear here, let us discuss one example. Now, say any person, say let us take a name, Raju. Raju is an employee of Mohan. Mohan is the employer, obviously. So now Mohan directs Raju to, bring some, say, raw materials from the market. The raw material for the product that they are manufacturing. Now, what happens is that Raju, this person, Raju, employee, he to go to the market, he hires a taxi. He pays 100 rupees, suppose. Now, in the market, for some refreshment, he had tea or samosa, in that he spends say 30 rupees. Now then he buys the cloth, raw material, anything. Okay, so now in this raw material he spends say 500 rupees, and then while returning he again hires a taxi and spends same amount, 100 rupees. Now, if we count the total amount, that is 100 plus 30 plus 500 plus 100, that is 730 rupees. Now, the 730 rupees will be paid by Mohan, the employer. So, this is what contract of indemnity means. Contract of indemnity can be simply, defined as protection from loss. Now let us see here one more example to be more clear. Alright guys, now let us see the next example. Suppose X is the owner of a factory and Y is the staff. Now Z is the third party and there is a dispute between Y and Z. Now this dispute was regarding some amount of money or loan which Y failed to pay to Z. Now, X promises to indemnify Y if any suit is filed against, you know, Y by Z. Now, Z files a suit in the court, and the court directs Y to pay compromise amount of 1 lakh and compensation amount of 1 lakh and cost of proceedings, say 1 lakh. Now, like earlier, the loan was, say, of 5 lakhs. Now, what happens is that X pays rupees 3 lakh. So, this is a situation of contract of indemnity. So, here we saw that X will indemnify rupees 3 lakhs to Y. That will include the compromise amount, the compensation amount, and the cost of proceedings. Now, guys, my question to you all is that what do you mean by cost of proceedings? If you know the answer, please comment down in the comment box below. And with this, I would like to end today's video. I hope you learned from my video. And for more such legal topics, stay tuned at Lexscape. Stay safe, stay healthy. Goodbye. Thank you.